Mr. Tulsian, I just wanted your thoughts on some of the numbers that came post-market hours, you know, Bhageria Industries, Z Media, etc. You've tracked some of these very closely. Anything that you would put incremental money into?
See, Sonia, in fact, Z Media came out with the numbers on Friday in the market hours, and we have already seen on market on Friday the stock hitting 20% upper circuit. So I think that if you really see the core business, even if you exclude the exceptional gain of about 41 crore, in fact, that is giving them a relief that they are out from the e-commerce business, which has been loss-making. And even from a loss-making business, they have been able to make up about 41 crore as an exceptional gain. And that is seen very positive. So now the Z Media is all with the news channel core business, print loss-making print business is out, e-commerce loss-making business is out, and now all the eyes are on the acquisitions of the 54 Radio City channel. And if that also goes through, because there has been some kind of dilly-dallying scene, and if that happens, it will all be seen extremely positive, because their core businesses seem to be doing quite well. Coming on Bhageria Industries, as a matter of disclosure, let me say that I'm a director on the company, and again, company came out with excellent numbers, and probably this is the highest quarter, you know, having posted by the company in its lifetime. And if you really see the four times, in fact, the synergy has come because of the merger of the Nippur Chemicals also with the company has made. And if you take an EPS of about 8 rupees, you know, 8 rupees 17 paisa against 2 rupees 25 paisa on a YOY basis, and even on a sequential basis, the things have been looking quite good. Because again, let me draw extend it further, that this gives the comfort on the dye and dye intermediate space also, because of the China factor and all that, and the demand which we have been seeing. China is every day, you know, that is what we have deliberated, and you know, we have that's what I have found, that China is seen, you know, becoming an importer every day, and that is seen quite positive. Apart from this Rajratan Global, you know, which are making the bead wire for tire, they came out with excellent numbers, and the PAT has been at 8.5 crore against 3.55 crore with quarter one EPS of closure to about 20 rupees. Actually, this Rajratan Wire, they had a tough year for FY18, but I think now their Indonesian company and the Indian operations both are doing well, and I won't be surprised in extrapolating the same Q1 numbers, you know, for the whole of FY19 as well. So with 20 rupees EPS of Q1, I think the stock again should come on the radar of the, and even coming on the L&T Finance holding, I think it is only because of the Ind-AS treatment we have seen that increase in the net NPA to 3.17%, and that has also been, you know, treated quite positively with 1,300 having provided or registered with the reserves. And if you really see their core business, you know, whether it is stock of retail, wholesale, everything is doing quite well. In fact, there has been sequential as well as YOY substantial growth on the earnings of all these three or four verticals. So keeping positive view on all these three, four numbers which I've just discussed.